Alright, hi guys. How are you doing? Hopefully we're back again. I don't know why the stream keeps crashing over and over again. Must be a performance issue. It should be back up and running again. But that's the second time now it's crashed. Well, anyway, we've got another planet to colonize. Anyway, we've got another planet to colonize. Hi guys. So let's take a look at this one, shall we? Oh wow, look at this, plus 40% research, jeez. I would gladly spend 100 credits for that, but I want the benevolent points, not the pragmatic ones. Comet re-entered the solar system. Your scientists report the comet is at least partly artificial, a relic left in the Oort cloud by an advanced species. We're not going to throw these people into more confusion. Study the comet remotely. Kill the god, then tell them we did it. Mount part of the comet on a spike outside of our colony. That's pretty good. I'll take the benevolent option, and the pragmatic one's the best here. I would gladly spend 100 credits for the 40% research, but we'll take it. I wanted the benevolent points, so. Alright, this is another excellent planet. Feels like I've got a ton of good worlds on this one. And we did get plus 10% anyway. Haley, good suggestion. Of course, we have to leave the screen to do that. And who knows, this wouldn't be a bad world to use for manufacturing, so I'd have two manufacturing worlds. I wish they weren't so close together, but I would like to have a second manufacturing. Yeah, and this one's got the social manufacturing bonuses. We'll use this as a production planet, have two production worlds. I don't know if I'll need two production worlds, but you know what, we might want to do some ethnic cleansing in this game and just kill everybody. I don't think it would be that hard to do. I think we might want to do that. And then we'll use these two. Wow, I can put a ridiculous amount of manufacturing down here. Holy cow. That's a lot of factories that have room for that down there. All right, so these give bonuses to wealth and an adjacency to research. All right, we could ignore that. That's not useful for us. So yeah, let's get some factories going. I'll put the farm here and the hospital here. The farm taking the bonus from the colonial capital. Or do I even need to do that? I can put the farm and the hospital over here. Morale stuff up here. Screw it. We'll just go straight away to building factories. Let's get three of them to start. That'll keep it for the time being. Alright, so I need to go through all my colonies. Wow, I like that. Look at that image. That planet looks totally different than all the others. I just realized that. Most of them are blue, but this one's gray. Ooh, it's like an ice planet. Cool. That's neat. Oh, one other thing I should mention. This game has some really neat graphics. If you look in the background, it's kind of hard to see, but the planet is slowly rotating back there. And what you see on the planet map is exactly what you see here. So, like, that geography is mapped to the planet in the corner, which I think is pretty neat. There's a lot of neat, a lot of neat stuff going on. Sadly, every time the stream crashes, the viewer count crashes as well, which is unfortunate. But yeah, I'm still here. I'm still trying to stream. Been a little bit off. Playing Benevolent Tree suggests ethnic cleansing to solve the galaxy's problems. You're darn right. Hey, Benevolent gives morale bonuses, which let you be more aggressive in invading other worlds. Anyway, we need to go through every planet because we want to put hives down on every world if we can. Okay, so we do want that missionary center. So where is the hive? Here it is. Cost 30 production, plus 4 raw, and it gives a bonus to everything. So that's pretty nice, too. Gives a bonus to absolutely everything. Alright. So, screw it, we'll put it here, in the middle of... And we want to build these first because they're cheap. Like, what's the raw production? 17. Alright, so it's 17 right now. The hive will add 4 to that, so that's like a 20 to 25% bonus. From one building. That's... really good. Their tech tree is kind of overpowered, I have to admit. So the planetary soil, and then we'll put a hive on that tile there. Alright, McFly, stop researching for a minute. And build a hive, and then build more stuff after that. Here is not a bad spot, I guess. What are we looking at? Alright, yeah, approval. We will need a morale building, too. Sorry, so build that there. was thinking of building a research lab there, but the hive works just as well. Gives a bonus to everything. So we'll build that. 30 tech. Also needs, we'll also put a hive down. I mean, we're going to build a hive on every planet that can fit it, which is almost everyone. I mean, this does give a bonus to everything, so it doesn't really matter where we put it. Why don't I use my terraforming here? And then I'll put the hive so that it gives a bonus to the entertainment center and the Xeno farm. I think that that will work pretty good. Because I always like giving bonuses to farms, and your planets can grow larger. Also, we're going to... Wow, we're going to need... look at this. We're already up against the morale. We're going to need to get more morale stuff soon, too. Look at that. We're already running up against it here. That large empire penalty can be rough sometimes. So what the hive does is it increases raw production. Basically, it improves everything. So, like, if you put it towards manufacturing, see how the base, like, the base manufacturing is 14.4. That's the raw production. See, like, right there, 14.5. I don't know why it's 14.4 here, but that's where that number comes from. Watch, if we swap it over to research, boom, 14.4, base research. So that's what the raw production is. So the hive increases the raw production, which means it improves your colony's ability to do everything. Manufacturing, research, gold. That's why that building is so incredibly good. But anyway, so we'll put that down here and then put the hive down on that tile. Because why not? Okay, Deed of Worms sadly has no space for a hive right now. You know what? Destroy the factory, replace it with a hive. That's the way to go here. On a little planet like this, the hive is much better than the factory would be. There we go, yeah. Because that'll take, like, that'll improve production and when we're doing manufacturing, and it will improve research when we're not doing production. Yes, when we're not doing manufacturing. It's pretty broken, yes. There's a reason why people say the Thalen tech tree is the best in the game, and it probably is. It's definitely better if you get more planets, too. The more planets you have, the better it gets. Okay, we'll just put this in the middle here, because remember, the hive gives a bonus to everything, so there's not really a bad place to put it. Like, it doesn't mess up your placement of buildings, either. Alright, so yeah, here we were doing planetary soil. We're going to build the farm there. That's fine. Yeah, we'll put the soil here and then maybe put the hive there. Actually, we don't really need this. Just we'll keep that there, but let's do the hive first. I'll put it right there. It'll be next to research buildings, but guess what? That's fine, because the hive boosts everything, so you're not losing anything by doing that. Yeah, basic factory, that's good. Let's queue up a hive afterwards. Money bin is going to be the market planet again. I'll put it here, and then that'll give a bonus to the farm that we're going to build and the hospital, which are going to go on those tiles. I would have been building hospitals already, but they don't do anything until I get more tech. All right, basic factory, that's fine. Arnhelm, we don't really know. We're just going to do research here, I think, so. That. Queue up the hive. Jurassic World. You know, I shouldn't be building a factory first. I should build the hive first, because look at this. Raw production's 9.4. It'll go to 13 afterwards, so screw the basic factory. Build the hive first. It's a better building. And we want to put it in the middle where other stuff can benefit from it. So let's see, I'm going to put the entertainment building there. You know, I actually want to put the hive on this tile right here, because then three buildings can get benefit from it. That might be overthinking it. We'll just put it down. Better to get it down first. And Haley. Do the hive first. As I said, it's pretty overpowered. Alright, so all that stuff looks good. So we're not doing any research at all right now, but that's okay. It's better to build this. By the way, it gets even more broken later on the tech tree, so watch. If I go back here, I mentioned hive specialization is good. Check out this one, Gaia Theory. Lets you build this. Gaia Vortex increases the overall production of all our worlds, plus 4 raw production, on every planet. You can only build this once, but plus 4 raw production on every planet. And look at the adjacency bonuses, plus 3 to adjacent research, approval, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, that's pretty broken. And then this is the upgraded version of Hive, Mother Hive. It goes from plus 8 raw production to, from plus 4 to plus 8, but that comes very late in the game. It's the early Hive, and then this Gaia Vortex is beyond broken. Like, you build it one place on one planet, and you get that plus 4 raw production everywhere. So what people are doing is they're using the Thalens in games with, like, ultra-humongous maps, where they get, like, hundreds of, like, 100 planets and just exploiting these per-planet bonuses. So we're not even doing that, and I can already see how strong, like these guys do have a great tech tree. Their racial traits aren't that great, but their tech tree is pretty awesome. All right, now they're up to 6 of these ships. I don't know if I'll be able to kill these pirates anymore. They got a lot of HP. But we'll probably take them on anyway, just to find out whether we can kill them or not and make it more interesting. So, the only part of the map that is not explored is the Deep South. Alright. So, Baba Yetu, alright, finished its terraforming. Done. Alright, we finished the Hive here. Jeez, alright, so look at that. The Hive is like getting a... It's basically like you get a second colonial capital, which is pretty ludicrous. So, like, look at this. This planet has 2 factories, and it's already got pretty good manufacturing. I have no idea what a Gaia Vortex is. That's one of those things that's probably better not to ask. Anyway, so yeah, what do we need? Let's get the farm and the hospital down. Yeah. Farm. Hospital. Entertainment center. And then we have terraforming available, so we can do more stuff. Probably terraform actually this tile here, because it's next to the capital and the hive. Okay, so Dirty Tech finished its terraforming. I wanted to put the hive down there, and that's good for this turn. Oh, we apparently wait. Where are we getting all this research from? 13. Oh. Oh, apparently that was just overflow. The only planet doing research is Deed of Worms, which, by the way, is producing a pretty good amount of culture already. Or influence, I'm sorry. This is Galactic Civ. They don't produce culture, we produce influence. So, wait. This planet shouldn't be doing... Wait, where is my research coming from? No planet should be on research right now. Alright, wait. There it is. Thala. Okay, Thala's doing it because it was getting overflow. Alright, that makes sense. But now that it's finished its hive, I just want to go full on and finish the missionary center. And I'd like to get some missionary centers up too for that benevolent culture production. You know, there's no more planets to grab for ideology points. Where are we? We're at 20, and the next policy comes at 50. So we need 30 more points, and that'll give us a free tile on every planet. That's awful nice. And then eventually this, maybe. I don't know if we'll ever get there, but we'll see. So yeah, everybody's building hives, looking good. Now we're, again, notice how we've solved the morale problem. Every planet's got 100% morale, which is what we want. That was the second big thing. Alright, this is one more turn to heal. So we'll attack this next turn. Well, merge them together and attack next turn. We'll probably lose that fight, but it'll be fun to try. Alright, the Drangan, that's not a planet, that's a starship. Starbase, excuse me. Starship. So they might have something down here, but I'm not seeing a whole lot. Obviously, there's no more planets available. Dirty Tech finished its hive. Wow, 36. Jeez. So I've played this game a decent amount, not like ridiculously, but a fair amount, and that is a lot of production for a planet with 2 factories that are, you know, basic, not Xeno factories, not Mega factories, and only 6 pop. So yeah, that's pretty nice. Dirty Tech, yeah, now Dirty Tech, I can't believe I keep saying this, this is so silly. Now Dirty Tech just needs to fill this out with as many research labs as it can. And I would like that missionary center at some point, but I'd like to put it next to the entertainment center. We're going to need to research more. We need to research the Tier 2 morale building at some point. That we can do that relatively soon. All right, let's get these down. Just fill out the rest of the spots. We've already used terraforming here. And then we want the planet to grow. Like, look, it's nowhere close to the food cap. Look, got a long way to go. Let's see. Yeah, if we can get the next level colonial hospital, that'll... Yeah, we need to get that Tier 2 hospital. That's what we're going for next. Still got a ways to go. Cultural festival at Deodor Worms. Oh, wait a minute. Are we... okay. So, Deodor Worms should not be sinking all this into the cultural festival. It should be doing research. And one production into the cultural festival. Yeah, that's more like it. That's more like it. So we get a... Wow, even this little planet gets 20 research. That's pretty good. I mean, it has no research labs at all. So that's not bad at all. Are we going to do another Civ 4 video? Well, we're hoping to do another Civ 4 AI event. I actually completely forgot that I'm supposed to send... I'm trying to schedule this with Brick Astley from Realms Beyond, and it's my fault. He responded to the message I sent him, and I totally forgot to send a response back. We're trying to schedule that sometime in the near future. There's like this Civ 4 AI Survivor thing that we're trying to set up that should be neat, and we'll try to do that for Civ 4. Honestly, I don't have a great desire to play Civ 4 because I've kind of played that game to death. So I don't have a huge desire to play Civ 4, but I would like to do more of the Civ 4 AI stuff. Anyway, so good question. I got to remember to do that. So we've got a battle here. I have three ships here. The survey ship that I started with, this ship that I got in the ship graveyard, and then my unarmed scout. So these ships that I'm up against are individually weaker, but there are a lot of them. And unfortunately, they have point defense, which is what most of my weapons are. So I think if I have to guess that I'll probably lose this, but I'm still going to try the battle anyway. Let's just see. I do have more hit points than the enemies. Yeah, it says I'm pretty seriously outgunned. But if we can kill their ships fast enough, that could make the difference. Because remember, we'll be killing their ships faster than they're killing mine, because mine have more HP. Now, when they kill this ship, though, is when it's going to get bad. And this ship's probably not going to last that much longer. Because that's like half my offense right there. Alright, so I lost my small ship. Now they're going after the survey ship. How many of the pirates have we killed? We've killed three of the... Well, we killed three of the six pirates. We might survive this after all. Alright, so that's another one down. Or it will be when the animation finishes playing. So as we kill them, their offense does decrease. 26 HP. What's my survey ship at? 53. Oh, this is going to be close, I think. And my survey ship's below half HP, but we're down to... There's only one of them left alive. Oh, and it only... Oh, yeah, we're going to win this because they only have two lasers. They have not gone after my unarmed support ship at all. What is this? There we go. Just like kind of hanging out for a minute there. Wait, we missed our last couple shots. Ooh, that's not good. 17 HP again. Wow, apparently I'm missing my shots. Or something like that. Or it's not displaying correctly. It's actually very close between these two. Well, it's saying this ship is getting damaged, but it's not showing up on here. I honestly have no idea which ship's going to win at this point. Oh, we won! Wow, that was very close. It said I didn't lose any units, even though I did. Cool. Looked like there were a lot of misses at the end there. Alright, so we killed those pirates. There was not really any need to do that. Not like those pirates were doing. Wait, what? What? Did you guys see that? It just said I won the battle, and yet there's one pirate sniper alive and all my ships are dead. What the heck? This game is so buggy. I just don't understand how this game can be released when it's still this buggy. Alright, so apparently no, we lost the battle. Okay. I mean, it didn't really matter, but it was just like, what? Yeah, so that happened. Alright. In any case, we'll go see what we can spot about, see what we can spot down here. The only unexplored part of the map. Anyway, so Thala, the homeworld, finished its hive, and now it mostly just needs to grow. But oh, we still have terraforming here, too. Alright, so morale looks pretty good. I guess we should just finish filling it out with factories right now. Yeah, why not? Do the terraforming, and then fill this out with factories. This plant will have pretty disgusting production. Put it on 30. Manufacturing, there we go. Put the rest in research. That was weird. Anyway, so this brand new planet already, it basically doubled its manufacturing by building the hive first. Really good at getting up and running first. All right, Baba Yetu is done. All this, so let's put it on research spending, because why not? Not really much else for it to do. Well, that's not true. Actually, it could. Actually, that's. Do we want to do research, or do we want to build a couple constructors? It looks like the AI's already grabbed most of the resources that they would want. I said I was going to look to get something here. Let's get one constructor and just build something in the middle of the map, because that would be out of range right now for most of my ships. Now let's build one constructor. Alright. So. Production. Military. And same thing at Thala. 100% production. And then on social versus military. We need 30 in social, and the rest can go into military. All right, that'll build a constructor pretty quickly. Yeah, we don't really need all this stuff. We just really want a starbase. Maybe like one over here. Maybe one for this resource cluster, and then one here at this Thulium. Just so we have range, basically. That's the main idea. Okay, Atlantis finished its hive. Atlantis, that's another research planet, I think. Yeah. Look at this. This population can grow. The population can grow to 12.6. It's at 2.7. So this is why we need hospitals so desperately. Again, we would be growing at 0.2 per turn, but that infertile penalty is pretty brutal for the moment. So where's our terraform? Okay, we can terraform anything. Every single land tile is available. So let's get some... we're going to need... Yeah, we need to cover morale next. That's right. All right. So, we'll do this. Planetary soil right here. Morale building here, and then entertainment center, and then missionary center next to it on those tiles. And then I'll just toss research labs up here, because why not? Something like that. All right, Havana's good on. All right, let's see. Let's get the. Put the farm down. Why not? While we're here. Money bin. The one research. The one money planet, or will be eventually. Okay, morale's good for the moment. Yes, not forever, but for the moment. So I'm setting up the hospitals right now, so I can upgrade them later. Wow. Okay, why is everything popping up? Because they all just finished hives. Okay. Do we need another factory on this planet? It's pretty small, right? Planet class 8. Yeah, let's. I don't know. I don't think we need a factory. We've got the hive here. Well, maybe one. Hold on. How do I want to put this down? I have not used terraforming yet, so I have that available. All right. So we're gonna put the morale building here, That's got the big approval bonus. Morale here. Missionary center here. Farm and hospital. Yeah, I can fit a factory on this world. That's fine. Alright. Anyway, so yeah. We've got a little trickle of research coming in, which is what we want. So basically, all the planets are filling out infrastructure right now. We're on a very heavy infrastructure kick. All the planets are filling out their tiles. Alright. Let's see what we can spot down here. So, Drangan has two planets right now. Drangi and Kona, I thought I saw a second ago. Oh, there it is. What the? Oh, there. Okay, we should have just having trouble seeing that. So yeah, this is why it would be nice to have a starbase over here, because then I could slip back here and see if there's anything down there. Instead, we'll just pop along on the outside of Drangan territory. So why not? Did we finish that constructor yet? No. Alright. Wow, this planet's just about filled out, isn't it? Approval looks good for the time being. I will use the last tile that's available, and have I used terraforming? No, I haven't used terraforming here. Okay, cool. Terraform here. Wait, everything builds so fast. I'm used to this stuff taking longer. Terraforming there. Let's get a missionary center. I know. Well, actually, no, not there. Screw that. Put the missionary center there. It'll get the bonus for... It'll give the entertainment center its bonus. Why not? It won't benefit the research lab, but that's okay. So basically, yeah, every colony's finishing stuff incredibly fast because those hives are so freaking good. Really, really strong buildings. Okay, what have I not done? I did use terraforming here. I used it to put the farm down. Morale's, wow, morale's really good. Okay, so we don't have to worry about morale here for quite a while. Let's just fill it out with research labs then. There, 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 there. I mean, I don't see any... Well, no, never mind. Cancel the last one. Use it for a missionary center. It's somewhat wasted over there, not giving a bonus to anything, but... whatever. Morale's fine on this planet. Probably could have done the SimCity a little bit better there. That's okay. Alright, Arnhelm, just another generic research planet. The one factory and a hive is probably plenty. It's already at 20. Yeah, that manufacturing is pretty good. I don't think we need it. It's only at 1.1. Look at this. It has this much manufacturing at one population. That's pretty crazy. It's going to be able to go up. It's going to be able to go much, much higher than that. Those hives are just broken, man. Really, really good buildings. Okay. Let's get the farm and the hospital up. Because why not? I'm debating whether to put them here or here. Probably up here. Hospital. We have terraforming available. Alright. So it's very quiet in the game right now. By the way, notice how my influence is winning over here. Not having much trouble pushing back the influence there. And in fact, we're going to take over more tiles. I see, like, this is going to flip to me really soon. We finished... Alright, so we finished soil enhancement. The only reason we wanted that was to get to this tech. Xeno Medical Center. Oh, I see. There's a 10% growth bonus that's innate to this. And it also allows for birthing subsidies, too. Alright, cool. Done. Alright, so that's our next tech. What does it say right now? 8 turns. Well, we'll have some... We have some planets that are going to start finishing finishing stuff. And we'll be able to contribute. Oh, wow. Did we finish that constructor? Yes. Yes, we did. All right. You get down here and try to grab this. See, the constructor also has 12 movement points, so it's pretty fast. As I said, I want one more constructor for the moment. We'll probably end up building more of them later. Put it down right next to that shipyard. Pirate shipyard. No, the hives come really early on the tech tree. It's like the second... I think it's one of the first techs you can research. It is literally the first tech you can research in the game if you want. What I did was I used my free research to grab really fast engines, and that's how I was able to get so many planets. That's how I broke the game, by going for super fast engines. That was the way I abused the Thalens, but no, the hives are available immediately. You don't have to do anything to research them. All right, so I said Missionary Center right here, because that'll give them morale bonus, and that'll keep this planet happy for a while. And then we can just toss another research lab over there. So you see how having 11 planets is about the limit of what I'd want. Too many more planets than this, and the game just starts to get really tedious. Even this is, like, doable, but it starts to get a little bit boring. So that's why I wouldn't want to play on one of those ridiculously huge maps. It just, you just spend the whole game micromanaging your colonies, and it's kind of silly. Alright, so approval's fine for the moment. Oh yeah, that's right. I said I'm going to put the entertainment center here, and then the missionary center here. That'll keep that planet busy for a while. Jurassic World? Jurassic World is such a silly name. Alright, yeah, we're going to terraform that tile. I don't really need anything just yet, so put the consulate down first. Then consulate first, then the entertainment center goes there, missionary center, farm, hospital. This isn't that much of a planet, but yeah, that works for me. Missionary center should probably be the last thing we build, though. Alright, let's do that, and then I'll look at that planet again when it's done terraforming. Alright. Haley, yeah, this is going to be a pretty good planet long term. Like, a pretty darn good planet. I'm going to do the farm and the hospital. Wow, it's already one turning these buildings. That's insane. This planet has three pop. Oh, I guess it did get the bonus pop because I had that extra policy. Alright, so we'll put them down there. Alright. See if there's anything down here in the bottom of the map. Not really. So again, in diplomacy, wow, we're really racing out in front. Let's look at the bar graphs for a second, shall we? There are bar graphs in this game. I think that's under diplomacy. No, I was just on that window. That's under govern. Here we go. All right, so faction power, wow. Our faction power is really taking off. Economic power, that's how much gold you have, or credits, whatever you want to call it. Military power, look at this. We suck, but we're... that was the one bad thing about losing these ships. Now our military power is down, and now the AI will view us as weak. Population. Wow, influence is really taking off. Raw production. Can you see when I started building the hives? Kind of takes off there. Military. Okay, so our research is low, but we're not really doing any research right now. Approval, treasury... ascension points. Some of them have ascension crystals. So this game's on, like, cruise control. And apparently I have a phone call, so I will be right back. All right. Sorry about that, guys. Just had to answer that call real quick. Apologies. Anyway, so what are we up to right now? Same thing we were doing before. So that would have been nice to get, a research relic, but would have been a little bit much to ask getting this research relic when I started down here, so that would have been a little difficult to pull off. Anyway, so we finished terraforming. Gonna finish the factory there, and I might as well fill out another factory spot there, because why not while we're at it? Social. That'll do it. Okay. Done. And what are we building? Oh. Well, that'll give us a lot of overflow that we don't need. Let's have this planet stop doing manufacturing, go over to research. If that's fine. That's all we need here on little Baba Yetu too. All right. So just finishing up here. I'm probably not going to play too much longer because I've been streaming this for a while now. Try to look for a convenient stopping point. I don't know. We'll see what we find. So recently you moved to Maryland. Let's see. Havre de Grace Seafood Festival. Nice. Can I suggest visiting? Well, if you've never been here before, the big things would be you want to go to DC if you've never been there before. There's so many things to see there. Between all the government buildings, the Smithsonian stuff, there's all kinds of stuff to see there. If you want to be more Maryland focused, there's a lot of great stuff in Baltimore as well. Baltimore has has the Inner Harbor. The aquarium is the biggest attraction there. You also have things like there's two different art museums that are not world beaters, but pretty good in Baltimore, the Walters and the Baltimore Museum of Art. What else? Fells Point is great if you've never been there before. If you like sports, go see a game at Oriole Park at Camden Yards. It's a beautiful stadium. A lot of good stuff. A lot of good, some good places to go get food, but that's getting a little bit too specific. And hold on, let me see what I'm doing here in game. Money Bin is the one planet that actually is going to produce, well, money, as the name implies. Have we used terraforming here? No, we have not. So that's good. We can terraform everything over there. All right, so I'd probably prefer to use terraforming over there. So what we want to add here is some morale stuff. Well, this is a bonus to wealth, so I'd like to put a wealth building there. Dang it. Why does this game always make it so difficult? Never mind. I'm going to put the entertainment center, and I'm going to put a missionary center over here, and then I'm just going to put wealth buildings over here. That's easily done. But yeah, Maryland's a great state. There's lots of stuff to see. If you like outdoor stuff and you are in the Baltimore area, go see places like Patapsco State Park, which is really close to where I grew up. I heavily recommend going to see some of the stuff on the Eastern Shore in particular. If you want to go see Assateague in the summer, if you like to go camping, it's great to go there. Ocean City is kind of touristy and tacky, but can still be fun. We have planetary soil. Upgrade terraforming is available here. Arnhelm, what do we need? Morale will be probably what we want to do next, just to get it out of the way. Cue these up. If you like more hiking stuff, you can go on the Appalachian Trail in Western Maryland. There's skiing in Western Maryland in the winter. It's a neat state. There's a lot of cool stuff to do. I think that's true of most places, of course, but Maryland is where I grew up and where I've lived pretty much my whole life. Oh, look at this. The Drangen are very kindly attacking and fighting the pirates for us. Very nice of them. Now they're going to get killed by this pirate, probably. They took 19... Yeah, they took... Whoa, what the hell? Look at this. They have 16 points of shielding, but they have very little in the way of weapons. That's kind of silly. I don't know why they would do that. Yeah. AI is kind of stupid in this game. So we apparently have quite a bit of culture down here. Or influence, I'm sorry. Influence. And now we're at the point where we just tell them to auto-build construct. Well, that's not true. We might as well make use of our trade routes. Let's design a trade ship and get some trade going. If the game doesn't crash again. Ox, it seems as though there's a... No. All right. We still good? No, it says we're still streaming, thank goodness. So we need a new design, although it's going to be very similar to... Actually, you know what? Let's take one of my... new design. Must select a home. Fine. Alright, so where is the freighter? Use the freighter design. Alright, so we're going to use this to set up some trade. Same thing as before, cargo module. Get a whole bunch of ion drives for extra movement. And then, let's see, what is that? 12 moves? That's pretty good. And then we'll get some extra range on it. Hi, Destroyer Phoenix. Hey, Lucifer. How do I pronounce that? Lucifer? It's a pun on Lucifer, I see. Rather clever. And then we want support stuff. So, let's see. Trade ship. Long range. Oh, I don't need the long range. All the trade ships are always long range. Alright, there we go. And we'll build a couple of these. Build a pair of these. I might as well fill out... I have two available trade routes. I might as well use them right now. This constructor, come over here and get those. Anyway, glad that you're able to watch some of the Civ 4 AI stuff, live or recorded. That's why I save it. So I know everybody can't always make it when it's live, so I'm glad you're able to catch one of the streams live. I typically stream around the same time, which is like Friday in the late afternoon, early evening, same time Saturday, and I do that just because that's when it's convenient for me, but I know that's not convenient for everyone else, unfortunately. So anyway, this planet's just about done with its infrastructure. McFly will be able to start doing some research, and it should be able to research at a pretty good rate. So that's looking good. Oh, Dirty Tech's filled out all its stuff. Look at this. Filled all this stuff. Yeah, so I don't think there's anything more to build. Do I have terraforming? No, I use terraforming here. Okay. We'd like to get a missionary center. We'll probably use our next terraforming to get a missionary center or something like that. But guess what? We can just do research now, and this planet can do a lot of research. 67. What I like to do to, as a reminder to myself that I am doing research on a planet, is to set it so it doesn't pop up in the queue constantly. So we'll set it to cultural festival. So that'll give it the 10% influence bonus, and that'll let me know that that planet's doing research. How do the Terrans compare? Okay, so was Lucifer an actress? I don't know. I'm unfamiliar with, I don't know. I haven't heard that before. I don't know that much about, I'm not like a big, I've said this before, I'm not a big movie person or anything like that, so I'm not a good one to ask about stuff like that. Alright, so, we don't need another farm. I want the entertainment center and the missionary center, and then we're going all out on factories in this area after that. So anyway, to get back to Nakira's question, I think the Terrans are actually pretty decent. I think they're one of the better races in this game. Now, there's only 8 races in this game. Oh, what the? Hello? They just picked up the social policy, ideology that gives them a size 10 planet. Oh man, I wish I could beat them to this spot. I wonder. I very much doubt I can get a colony ship down there in time to stop them, but I almost want to try. Because this colony just, they just got this to pop up. Yeah, they really need something that says, hey, this planet's doing research. Like, I put them on cultural festival, but you know the other thing they could do? I've mentioned this before, so the little heads-up display tells you the morale, which is important, the population, that's also important, and then the money per turn, and that is not important. If they just replaced this with beakers, you'd be able to see what planets are researching, like, immediately. So, it kind of sucks, but yeah, they definitely need to, there's so much interface stuff that they should be doing in this game, and they're not. So yeah, I don't think I can possibly get a ship down here in time to stop them, but I don't know. We'll let the Iconians have this planet. By the way, they're already on Mega Factory, so they're ahead of me in tech. I expect that they'll colonize this, like, any minute. They probably have a bunch of colony ships sitting around. Oh, look at this. Drangan's getting attacked by the pirates. Alright. Oh yeah, we need the homeworld for this planet. Thala, sure. Now, I should have said it that Money Bin was the start for this planet, but that's okay. Let me see if I can set that up now. Shipyard. Edit sponsors. Yeah, I can. Money bin can be a. Alright, assign. Because money bin is going to be the planet that has all the, well, money attached to it. Alright, so set this back to social spending. And look, we got our hospital upgrades. Nice. That's fine. So this trade route's kind of going to the wrong place, but I don't really care that much. Look at this planet. They're producing 55 production, 58 beakers, and 6 credits per turn. And that's with 12 population. It shows how silly this all is. Abused so many loopholes. Terrans, yeah, okay, yeah, I was saying that and I got sidetracked by a whole bunch of other stuff. Yes, I think the Terrans are solidly, I think they're above average. I don't think that they're, like, overpowered or anything like that, but they have some pretty good stuff. I wish I could highlight their abilities. Because this, I don't think this game has, like, a Civilopedia or something. If they were in this game, I could tell you what they do, but they're not in this game. Oh, look at this, I'm 4th in tech power. Well, not for very long. Let's see, so we're still close with Iconia, and the others are... don't hate me, which is good. At least not for right now. So yeah, the Terrans get the bonus to production. They get the free... they get a free building. First building on every planet's free. That's kind of nice. Mostly they don't have any real disadvantages. They've got some decent stuff. They have plus one moves on their ship. So like, they're solid. They're probably like the third best out of 8, something like that, roughly. The Thalens are obviously pretty good because of their tech tree is so silly. People say the Yor is really good too because of how you can manufacture people. You can get extra population with manufacturing. I haven't played a game with them yet, so I don't know. I think Altaria is pretty decent in this game too. I'm not much on some of the other ones. Wait, why is this ship not moving? Go. There we go. Like, I don't think that... I think the Drangen are not especially great. Oh, hello. Well, we better build a starbase right now because this ship's going to die if I don't build one. It only has one move left, and it cannot escape these. So I guess we're building this... guess we're building the starbase here! Anyway, we want a mining ring to bring in the Thulium here. I might want to build a Thulium data center. I was like, well, I guess we're building the... guess we're building it right here. But that will extend my range. That's the main reason why to do that, is I just wanted extra starbase range for this corner of the map. Silly. There's probably a Drangen planet down there. They probably have 3. Anyway. Yeah, so the main thing is we finished another tech. We finished our hospital tech, so we need to choose something else. I'm going to go ahead and... I'm going to get Universal Translator so I can actually talk to the other AIs. It's a very cheap tech. I'm going to go ahead and grab that. And now I need to upgrade these hospitals. They cost, what, 45 to go to the Xeno? Yeah, 45. So right now, every planet's growing at 0.1 growth per turn. The Xeno Medical Center will take them to 0.2 growth per turn, and that's obviously pretty huge. So let's do that, shall we? I need 45 social spending to get this. And then after that, I'll probably end up building a gazillion constructors. Alright, same thing here. Gonna have to turn off research on some of these planets. Also, social, not military. For Baba Yetu. So the little upgrade shows. Oh, this one's still on. Oh, it just finished the research lab. Okay. Then we're gonna upgrade to tier 2 factories and research labs, will be a big priority coming up. So we need 45 manufacturing. Can we do it in one turn? No. Close, but no cigar. Right. Same thing here. Even though this little planet, you might say, well, why do we need to upgrade here? It's like, well, because it's at 3.5 pop and it can go to 10.8. That's got a lot of growing to do still. All right, so work on that. All right, just queue that up next. I want to do this before the Missionary Center. It's not as important. All right. Do them in the opposite order. All right. Keep that going. Oh, and I haven't built the hospital yet. Oops. Okay. So we've got the... All right. To the hospital. do the hospital first and get the planetary soil after that. Actually, no. I'm going to want to come back and upgrade the hospital first at Jurassic World. Alright. There we go. Just wanted to do them in the opposite order so these planets will grow faster. Alright, so all that's good. Don't sacrifice kittens, sacrifice Nasus. Why Nasus? Do people just not like him? He's not that strong right now in League, is he? I haven't seen anyone playing him in LCS or anything like that. And you know what? Before doing the trade ship, I'm gonna go for it. Build the colony ship. I doubt it'll be able to get down here in time, but whatever. We'll go for it. That's the first trade ship, right? Yeah. I would love to get this planet. That would be so hilarious. Again, I don't think that's going to happen, but it would be pretty awesome. So we have our first resource. Thulium can be used to build the Thulium data center. And you know what? I'm going to move my scout ship over here to see if there's any colony ships about to jump in there. Oh, it takes two turns to build this? Not quite enough production to build in one turn. I should have one turn that. Oh well. Now we can go full-bore military. 117 production, that's pretty good. Especially with no upgraded stuff there. Do I pay any attention to Civ 5 AI stuff? No, I'm completely unaware of that. The only thing I heard is that some guy was doing a Civ 5 AI game with, like, and it, like, took forever. It was, like, every turn took, like, an hour to play, and it was just kind of, like, automated. That's the only thing I heard. So, no, I don't know anything about that. That's a good point, but I'm not, other than, like, being very generally aware that there's something like that, I'm unaware of it. So now the population grows at 0.2 per turn instead of 0.1, and that makes a huge difference. So we basically went above a tipping point. You have to get to plus 50% overall. So what are we at? Plus 10, minus 10, that cancels. Minus 30, plus 55, plus 25. What is that? That's 80. Oh, we're at exactly plus 50, because we're at that. It adds up to exactly plus 50, and this game does not track extra decimal places, only to one decimal point. So now we're growing at double the rate we were growing before, and I'll turn research back on. So let's do that and queue up cultural festival so we know that we're doing research here, because the game's interface doesn't tell us otherwise. That's the idea. All right, I wanted to queue that and then do the planetary soil upgrade, because I want this to grow. I want this planet to grow. It's got a long way to go. It's only at 3.4 out of 8. So he's trying it with 61 AIs? Ugh. I don't know. Well, whatever people enjoy. Hey, whatever you enjoy doing. I would not try that personally. Also, the Civ 5 AI sucks at anything, so the Civ 4 AI, look, the Civ 4 AI is not smart, but it can capture cities. Like, we see AIs get eliminated all the time in Civ 4 AI Survivor. I don't think the Civ 5 AI is very good at capturing anything. Boy, that planet's lasted longer than I thought. Still there for the time being. And that is a trade ship, not a colony ship. Ooh, who should be United Planets chair? I think I should be United Planets chair. And let's see. You know, guess what? The Iconians actually voted for me. Cool. Maybe we don't have to kill the Iconians. So they have 23% of the votes. The Yor have 19%. Wow, these guys are even weaker than the Iconians, and they only have two planets, so that is not good for these guys. The Yor, oh, by the way, here's another interface issue. The Drengen voted for themselves, but it's really hard to see that because the D is under the interface. And I think the Yor voted for themselves too, but it's hard to tell. Anyway, we had more than enough votes to take that. Alright. Again, let's see, look at that. It didn't end up mattering. Look at that. We weren't able to... they did, in fact, claim that planet before I could get down there. I thought they would, but I went for it. It was worth the effort, I think. Anyway, let's explore what's in their little back lines over here. That's fine. I will keep the colony ship in here. Oh, wait, no. I already moved them out. I'm going to put this inside Let's put it in Baba Yetu for now. I will show you later, probably not today, in another streaming session, I will demonstrate the abuses you can do with transport ships, and colony ships too. Actually, no, you can only do them with transports, not with colonies. Or can you do them with... Actually, no, you can do the abuses with colony ships. Transports or colonies. You can basically ignore the population cap in this game, which is not the way it should work. In any case, though, this planet has done upgrading. We are now growing at 0.2 per turn, instead of 0.1, as expected. This planet's also going to need some approval stuff, but... we can do that with more research. So social spending, research probably. I know there's no research buildings on here, but that's okay. And cultural festival, because it's the only way to know we're doing research on the planet. Birthing subsidies would do nothing. It would just give us 10% growth. That doesn't actually do anything. So Universal Translator will finish, and then we can actually talk to the AIs and see what they've got. First, though, we can... What the? What's going on? How are the AIs moving when it's my... What the heck is going on? That's so weird. I was, like, in the process of building a starbase, and the AI was moving at the same time. God, this game is buggy. Anyway, we do want a starbase, and we want it as close to the AI as possible, because, again, I think the long-term solution in this game is going to be ally with the Iconians and kill the Yor and the Drengen, and we can win the game that way, but that's still down the road. All right, this is a resource starbase as well, so mining ring. That gives us... another Thulium and a Durantium. Alright, we did finish Universal Translator, so that's nice. This also allows us to build influence star bases. I generally don't do a lot on the Diplo part of the tree. Generally just don't see that to be too helpful. Let's get the next level of entertainment center. See this one here? Entertainment Capital. Here it is. Entertainment Network, that's the next one that increases that. And then this one's good too. So like this is a really useful path because this gets you morale stuff. The stadium is the tier 3 morale building, and it gets you tourism, which increases your income passively. So it's really useful to head down there. The only other thing we might, well, I guess the question is, how badly do we need morale? I'm not sure we need it. Actually, we should be going on morale for right now. We will need it soon, but because we don't need it immediately, let's go for the Xeno factories and the Xeno labs. Get us to tier 2 factories and tier 2 research labs. I think that's probably the next thing we want. All right. Meanwhile, hey, remember when they put down a starbase over here? Yeah, they kind of got swallowed up by my culture, didn't they? Come on, game. There we go. Finally. Alright, I don't think there's anything back here, but just in case. Alright, you hang out in Baba Yetu. So that adds 0.5 pop to Baba Yetu. Thala is actually one of my lower pop worlds because it's sent so many people off world. Alright, so we got the two trade ships, and now we probably just need to build some constructors for economic star bases. We can definitely use a couple of them. I don't know how many we want to build. All right, Atlantis finished its missionary center. We've got a couple missionary centers now. And with what's left over, did we use terraforming here? Yes, we did. Get some research labs. Knock those out quickly. Let's see, Haley. Oh, this is my other production world, I said. So it's got all its stuff set up. Approval looks good. Got planetary soil that we can use for terraforming. I think the terraforming needs to go right here. Dump another factory in there. Trade offer, what the, oh. They are offering ultra spice for open borders. I don't care about open borders. Well, they have fixed up this setup. Previously, the AI would just give you open borders for free at all times. I mean, if they just want to sign a straight-up open borders deal, I'd be willing to do that. Where is open borders? Here it is. Open borders for... How about open borders for open borders? Why can I not pick that? Maybe I don't have the option to do that yet. Anyway. Yeah, I'm not trading one of my resources for that. Look at all the resources I have. I have 8 resources, they have 2. Let's see. Declare war on... They don't even have that many more ships than I do. They have 7 star bases. By the way, the AI loves to build star bases. They have no planets! They have one! They have one planet! What the heck? Also, what's up with the old man star base? What is up with this? But yeah, they have one planet. Because they don't have any colonies popping up here. Just their capital, that's it. Alright, screw you. That's all. Let's actually check in with the other AI. So they have one planet. That's it. Let's check in with the Drangen. Again, it doesn't look like there's a way to offer open borders for open borders. Maybe it's just, maybe every open borders is bilateral. That's all I can think of. All right, sure. Okay, well they had 2 planets. I'm happy to sign open borders. It doesn't bother me. The AI just moves through your territory anyway. Doesn't really matter. I don't want to trade for Levenstrom. So the Drangen appear to be in 3rd. The Yor in... Wait, the Iconians are in 2nd. The Drangen are in 3rd. The Yor are in 4th. And so they... Let's see. I'd be happy to sign open borders with these guys, too. They have 3 colonies. So none of the AIs got any planets outside their home system. Look at that. That's crazy. Every single planet on the map was taken by me. That wasn't in their home system, because the Yor have one planet. The Drangen start with Drangi, and then Kona's always in their home system, too. The Iconians start with New Iconia, and then Sanctum's always in their home system as well. And then this was the one they got from their ideology policy, whatever you want to call it. So none of them got a single planet outside their home system. That's ridiculous. Like, that's just crazy. I could probably go... I mean, I can go for any win condition here that I want... but I'll probably, like I said, I think I'll just try to ally with the Iconians and eliminate the other two, because that seems like the easiest thing to do. Jeez, that's really crazy. Alright, so we're losing money hand over fist, by the way, but we're almost to the point where Money Bin can, take over. Yeah, I need to start getting these market centers up quickly. Those trade routes will help a little bit, too. But yeah, I've got about 5 more turns before I run out of money. There's the first trade route, so we get a little bit of money from that. And our first Durantium mine. Not really planning on using that Durantium. So it's worth 6 gold per turn, 6 commerce per turn. That helps a little. Buy us an extra turn or two. So yeah, Money Bin needs to build these market centers. And it needs to do that before doing anything else, because we need these very badly. It's funny, we almost have enough to one turn them. They cost 30 production and I've got 26, so it's just a little bit short, but the population will grow and we'll be able to take care of that pretty quickly. So every turn, yeah, and then once these are done, I'll have to run some net income spending. We did finish the Xeno factories, so we've got a lot of upgrades to do. Like, a lot of upgrades, because I have tier 1 everything that can upgrade to tier 2 everything. And I want to check out this. I want to see if this actually gives +1 adjacency to every single building. I think it does, but I'm not certain. What's this one? Manufacturing +10, research +10. That's not that great. I'm curious about whether this actually works the way I think it does, which is just +1 adjacency for everything in the game. I don't know if that's +1 adjacency for everything or +1 for everything next to a hive. This is the second hardest difficulty. I wouldn't say that I'm a noob at this point. I've played this game enough that I kind of do know what I'm doing. But yeah, the AI, there's 7 difficulties. This is the 6th difficulty. So it is the second highest difficulty you can pick. But yeah, I am just destroying. So maybe I do have to play the highest difficulty. I don't know. Maybe the Thalens are just really strong. But yes, I am killing the AI. Just destroying them right now. Anyway, we got to go through, and yeah, we want to We want to configure all this stuff. So I can build a Durantium refinery, but I don't even think that it's that worthwhile to do so. I think I'd rather just... It only gives me a little bonus. So we're going to upgrade all the factories to Xeno factories, and that'll take a while. We need 45 production to do that, so 45 social. Put it at 46, get a little overflow. The other planets, it's a bit harder of a decision. Like this planet, I'm just going to leave this one alone. I don't want to go through the micro to upgrade. If I need to build... I guess while I'm doing this, I should. Too nice. Too much of a micromanager. Can't leave that alone. So, yeah. I want one planet to keep researching. Let's keep McFly researching because we did that before. Meanwhile, Dirty Tech is going to upgrade. Do the factories first because that increases the speed at which the other buildings get upgraded, obviously. Alright, oh, actually, this planet's been on manufacturing... apparently wasn't researching before. I hope it just finished something and it hasn't been wasting its time. Alright, Diet of Worms doesn't even have a factory or a Xeno lab, so there's nothing to upgrade. Do this, then this. Oh, wait. Do this, this, this. That'll keep you busy for a while. Alright, same thing here. Ooh, just about to finish that Missionary Center. Good timing. Alright, this, this, this. Money Bin, I know, needs to do the Market Centers. Yeah, upgrade the Xeno Factory while you're here. Jurassic World, upgrade that. Alright, do the basic factories, then upgrade them into Xeno Labs. Alright, that'll cover everything. Yeah, no, it's not even a Civ 3 habit, it's just, I can't avoid micromanaging, if that makes sense. It's like an itch that I have to scratch, basically. It's like, I can't just leave that alone. Inefficiencies just bother me too much. Yeah, that's kind of what it... That's how I'd have to describe it, is it just, it bothers me if I don't play the game efficiently. Anyway, so we have constructors, which means that we can set up star bases, and we want economic star bases. I'd love to get this... I'd love to get Thalen and Baba Yetu in one, but I don't... Nah, they're not going to fit. That's okay. So, I don't... Baba Yetu is pretty small. I don't think that needs it. Let's try and get one for Money Bin and Havana, because those are both good planets. I'd love to get all three of them in one, but that's not happening. I can get two out of three in one. So let's do the bottom two first. And we'll see how we can upgrade them. So yeah, star bases allow you to, you know, upgrade your planets further. Do some stuff along those lines. Look at this, there's still random ships running around. Alright, yeah, that's fine. We just built another constructor, too. Send this one along. So yeah, I'll be upgrade, build some star bases and upgrade them. Alright, finish revealing this corner of the map. There we go. So that whole map's revealed. And now, I do have open borders with the Drangan, so let's go reveal their territory, too. Oh, that was a fast turn. Interesting. That didn't take very long. How many more turns do we run out of money? Three more turns. Actually, two more turns. That's okay, though. We've got our wealth planet just about ready to come off of infrastructure, or whatever you want to call it. Alright, idle colony. Let's cut through our planets again. Because it's been a turn. Alright, so Thala is upgrading its stuff. Its manufacturing is getting ever more ridiculous. Baba Yetu is done upgrading, so put it back on research with its cultural festival, of course. Alright, McFly is just doing its research, the only planet on research right now. Building. Why is this planet on manufacturing? I guess it really likes that cultural festival. Was putting all its production into the cultural festival. Alright, the Deed of Worms does have very good influence, though. Alright, building, building, building. Oh, no, Arnholm's not building. Okay. This is... I think this is like light research here or something like that. Let's take advantage of the consulate. We're good on a happiness for the time being. Got all the basic infrastructure in place, and then we'll just put down some basic research in random spots. Well, we can terraform like crazy. If I ever reach the end, by the way, if you reach the end of the tech tree, you can terraform every single tile that lights up, but that's at a very, very end of the game tech. We're never going to get there. We'll win long before that happens, but yeah. Okay, I do need a Xeno farm, because that'll increase the pop cap significantly. And I'll put the missionary center there, and then that planet's good to go for a while. All right, this is really shaping up. This is, you know, I keep saying this, but the game's looking great. I have, like, no fear I would lose this game at this point. It's been fun to play, too. I've been enjoying this. Oh, there goes a colony ship. Or maybe that was a trade ship. They look the same on the map. All right, so we finished the research. All right, so let's see what that actually did. By the way, can I research the Gaia Vortex one? Can I research this tech, by the way? Because that would be awesome. Yes, okay, I can. You have to research 10 techs before you can go into the Age of War, and I've researched 12, so I just have enough. Yeah, let's get this ridiculously overpowered Gaia Vortex going. I'll just build that on the... Actually, no, I won't build that on the capital. I'll build that on Haley, and just put it right here in the middle of all these factories. Anyway, so yeah, now we got to deal with the money situation. So money bin, I want you to keep building those market centers, but I need you to put some of your money into wealth, or we're going to go bankrupt, basically. Okay, we need to put more money in wealth, more money into money bin than that. What if I go 100% wealth? What does that do? Okay, we're still losing money at 100% wealth. That's not good. Because that's my planet that's supposed to cover that. So we might need to go for tourism. Well, I am going to get a trade route right here. Where did my trade ship go? Or do I already have both trade routes and I'm still losing that much money? That would be... Hold on, where's... Govern... trade. Oh, I do have two trade routes, and I'm still losing that much money. That is not good. we need to... Alright, so what that means is hold off on Gaia Theory, even though I'd really like that. What we need to do is we need to get to interstellar tourism, because that'll enable tourism, and then that will solve my budgetary woes. So we want to head there. Okay, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to have my homeworld run some wealth for the time being. Alright, so do this, how do I want to do this? Alright, so put it to 100% social, and here we go. That'll get me 20 wealth per turn. I'll still be able to build those Xeno factories at one turn each. And then I can use that, let's see, money bin can continue building these. What if I went to full production? What am I at? Alright, 13. I need to put 13 gold per turn, if you want to describe it that way. Alright, so that will balance the budget right now, and that way those marketing centers will still be constructed, just not quite as fast. Alright. Is this game worth shelling out for? I don't know. It depends. It kind of depends on what you're trying to do with it. It does some things really well, but it does other things really poorly. It's not well balanced, unfortunately. And it has potential, TM, but I don't think it's ever going to reach its full potential. If you've been playing Civ 4 for 10 years, it's probably worth buying just to play something else for a change. But it's unfortunate that it could be a much better game, and it's just not very well balanced. I really hope that they'll solve some of the more egregious problems, but I don't know if they ever will. If you like doing a lot of weird variant stuff, this is a good game for you, because you can put self-imposed handicaps on yourself. If you want to play a game against other people in like cutthroat multiplayer, I wouldn't buy it, because it's very poorly balanced. Anyway, so we're going to build the starbase. We're going to build the economic ring, because that allows us to That's what allows you to upgrade. Basically, this provides bonuses for your nearby worlds. Like, you can increase manufacturing, and in particular, the Starbase market would be nice. It looks like we're good. Looks like we're okay. I'm not trying to make money, just keep it even right now, and it looks like that's the case. Alright, so we'll keep this here for right now. And I'm focusing on upgrading this Starbase first. I actually want both the manufacturing bonus and the wealth bonus here, which are both options you can get. Alrighty, so looks like we're good. Budget is mostly in good shape. We're going for the tourism to solve the budgetary woes. But that's fine. That's what you expect for this phase of the game. Our culture is very strong, our influence, whatever you want to call it. So I think we'll be, get quite a bit from the tourism. Basically, that's another complaint. It's too easy to balance the budget in this game. Like, you barely have to spend anything on wealth. And if they made it harder to balance the budget, then the game would be a lot more interesting. Like, here, we'll buy the Starbase market. And there's huge parts of the tech tree that do nothing but do upgrades. So maybe someday we'll do a game where we really explore the Starbase angle. Like, can only research techs from such and such and such. Or, like, have to focus, I don't know, some kind of variant setup that focuses on the Starbases. I don't know, it seems like there's the potential to do a lot of stuff. The AI, by the way, loves Starbases. If I were redesigning this game, I'd put something in that such that you can only have X amount of Starbases at your tech level. That's what I would look at doing. But that's, you can have infinite Starbases right now, and it can get very tedious micromanaging all the constructors. The only limit is every Starbase has to be 5 tiles away from another Starbase. That is literally it. And I guess that's it for this turn. I guess every planet's just upgrading infrastructure right now. Yeah, Xenofactory is out the wazoo. Research, research, upgrades, research. Almost done with upgrades there. Just queue that one up too. Upgrading. Got another market center, that's good. Cool. Upgrading. Upgrade that. Looking good. Upgrade, upgrade, upgrade. Alright, works for me. And we actually are making we actually are getting tech stuff too. Tech stuff. We are getting techs in. So yeah, we'll research for a little bit, build up until we have an unstoppable death army, and then we'll take out our enemies. But it's better to build up your economy first, obviously. Oh, look at that. The pirates helpfully killed an enemy ship. So that was kind of nice of them. So anyway, this gives us the next level of, what's it called? This gives us the next level of morale buildings, the tier 2 entertainment building. It also gives us the entertainment capital, which is a unique building. You can only put one of these. This is like a national wonder, basically. It gives you a big, big bonus to morale and influence on one planet. And look at the adjacency bonuses are quite nice too. And then this is quite nice too. Boost the approval of nearby worlds. This is a Starbase improvement. Now, if you really want to, like abuse this game, you can set things up so you build no morale buildings on your planets, and you just construct a gazillion. You can have more than one Starbase boosting a planet. You can actually have 3 or 4 Starbases boosting one planet if you set them up correctly. So you can do that, and then just stack a whole bunch of morale stuff on the Starbase, but that gets really tedious, and that's why I don't do that in my games. But you can, if you really want to be abusive, do that. So, like, we'll go over here. And now we can build the Starbase factory for 5% manufacturing or the recreation center. I'm gonna grab the recreation center. So now we get a morale bonus off-world. See, well, it hasn't popped up yet. I guess it has to wait till next turn, but it'll be there next turn. The balance, and so this game is, as I said, very poorly balanced, but look, see, now we can upgrade the entertainment center to the next level. And I think that there are some planets that are not at 100%, like this planet, Dirty Tech's not at 100% morale, so let's do that, and I'm going to put this at the top of the queue, so that that's the next thing done, just to keep it at 100% morale. So I kind of needed to get that anyway, was the thing. Alright, and every planet looks like they're building stuff, all looks good. We're just cranking out the constructors. Oh yeah, money. What are we looking at? Are we actually making? Yeah, we're actually slightly making money now. Let's finish that marketing center and then take another look at it, shall we? All right, you are scouting out Drengen territory, or at least as much of it as we can see. This little corner of the map's probably still going to be in out of range. That's okay though. You know, we could also go for an influence victory really easily from this point, just by spamming the in the what's it called? Influence star bases, that's it. I'm kind of curious to see how much interstellar tourism is actually going to give me in terms of money. I think it's going to give me a fair amount. So the Drengen, you know, they've got colony ships, but they have no place to send them. And they got a couple warships. What are they? All right, so let's look at what they're producing on their planets. 20 production, 26 research, and their capital is 70 production, 70 research. Again, not bad, but you know, I'm easily hitting that mark at this point. All right, we're fine on approval. Just basically, my planet's just got to grow. Look how far this planet has to grow. It's 9 pop below its current rate, so it takes 5 turns to grow. So that's going to take 45 more turns to max out. Jeez. It's a long time to max out. And there's not really anything you can do to speed that up. What turn are we on? So we're on turn 44. That planet won't max out until turn 90. That's pretty crazy. Yeah. So on this world, we might as well queue these up. Might as well try to work on these. That's going to take a while though. So we're good on the budget for right now. Slowly making some money. Interstellar tourism's in 2 turns. Just pretty quiet, just developing. Nothing too crazy going on. I'm really taking off in the game though. If you look at the, not the govern one. That's not the one I want. Oh wait, yes it is. I wanted the bar graphs. Here, timeline. That's what I wanted. All right, so in faction power, you can see I'm just getting stronger and stronger because I have 11 planets and the other AIs have 3, 2, and 1. Economic power, yeah, I suddenly finally started running some money. Military power, I still have no ships whatsoever. Population's taking off. Influence, looking pretty good. Much stronger than anyone else. Raw production, again, that's the hives exploding there. Social manufacturing, military, I'm not building any ships right now. Research, I'm not even doing research and I'm like equal with the AI. And like this is the second highest difficulty in the game. It's pretty silly. I guess I'll just have to play on the highest difficulty from here on out. Although to be fair, you're not going to land grab this successfully in every game. This is kind of a weird game. I have to be fair to the AI. This is, you're not often able to get this many more worlds than the AI. So, a bit of an outlier. It's not always this easy. Okay, Atlantis. Just about done with its stuff. Wow, this planet's really happy. Why is this one so happy? Oh, it's got the plus 20% water reclamation. Okay, that makes a difference. So upgrade that, and then you can start doing research. Same thing here. I think this planet's fine on happiness, but whatever. Keep it in place. And all right, Arnhelm. Do we need anything here? Just research stuff. Research lab, upgrade that. So it won't be much longer. I mean, most worlds are getting close to maxing out now. And once they're maxed out, we'll just do research and we just blow away the AIs in research. In fact, let's finish interstellar tourism. That's one more turn. And then I'm gonna have McFly start upgrading because it hasn't been doing that. Deliberately held that planet. Would you consider a gift of 75 credits? Sure, why not? Of course, that's going to put us in negative money, which is annoying, but guess what? Now that we have tourism. By the way, tourism is really silly. They put this in the game because they wanted a way to make influence more valuable, but it's way too strong. Look at this. Where's tourism? Tourism is like a huge amount of my income right now. Look at that. So anyway, we're in negative money right now, but that'll only last for a turn, so we'll let that fix itself. Tourism gives you tons of money for doing nothing, which is really silly. All right, so now we're good on morale, we're good on the budget, that's gotten solved. So what do we want to do next? Let's get stronger. Do we need the adaptive farm? No. No one's close to maxing out yet. Do we want terraforming? Yes. We probably do want terraforming. It's either that or... Yeah, I think terraforming would actually be the most valuable thing, is getting another terraforming tile. So I think we'll go for that. And then, well, then after that we can look to get to the Tier 3 research labs and the Tier 3 factories, because why not? No one's clearly NECA, so let's just keep going economy until somebody, you know, does something. What does this thing do? That's an influence building. More trade, whatever, we don't need more trade. Financial cap. We do want this. This is useful. We're going to want to put the financial capital on. We might as well grab this while we're down here on this part of the tree. This is very cheap. Not an expensive tech. So that'll allow me to put the financial capital, which is plus 200% wealth, and I can put that on this planet here. Where's planet? Yeah, I'll terraform right here and then put it down there, and then the financial capital will be giving bonuses to this world. Okay, that works for me. So basically, this is almost like a sandbox game where I'm just kind of playing around. Yeah, okay, so I'm not going to upgrade this. I can upgrade this again, but the approval morale's at 16.3, and we do not need to upgrade morale any further, so this planet can just do research. What the heck? What is this? Oh, we can't move the slide. Oh, okay. We can't move the sliders because we're in negative money. Oh, that's weird. I've never been in negative money before. Okay. Well, I guess we might as well upgrade then, because we can't change the sliders. That's weird. So that's what happens when you're in negative. You can't alter the sliders. Interesting. Okay. Huh. Yeah, so you can't change the sliders when you're in negative money. Well, I've never been in negative money before, so that's interesting. Anyway, queue this up. So we'll be out of negative money. That was only because I gave that gift to those whatchamacallit guys. Alright, so the homeworld can probably stop putting much money in. What if I set money bin to 100% money, or very close to it? Would that balance the budget? I got like 5 production per turn here. Thala, govern planet. Alright, what if we went back to manufacturing? Yeah, and this planet's actually, I could upgrade this as well. Might as well do that while we're on the subject. Go back to wow, this planet has a lot of manufacturing, doesn't it? Forced to make money, yeah. Alright, yeah, so we're good on money. In fact, we can even go, we're still in the black here by a pretty good margin. We can go a little bit heavier than that. So where was I at? 5? 41? Yeah, 10 manufacturing per turn. That'll mean it will still take a while to build this stuff, but not zero. Alright, that works. So yeah. Looking good. As I said, there's not too much going on. I'd probably better just run through all my planets real quick. Just to make sure they look good. Alright, so. Thala is upgrading this. Doesn't really have to, but it will, just because why not? Baba Yetu. Baba Yetu needs to upgrade this. See, this is why you gotta check your planets periodically. Baba Yetu was unhappy. That's why you need the morale buildings on planets. Alright, McFly. Oh, now we can change the settings. So McFly, start upgrading your stuff. Yep, we'll do the factories. Whoops. Wanna do the factories first. This planet actually has a lot of production. Alright. Do the factories first, then the labs. And this planet might as well... 30 tech might as well get the stadium done while we're on manufacturing, because that approval doesn't have a lot of headroom there. How about worms? Worms is fine for now. Just keep it on research. Atlantis, is it done with everything? Nah, well, not its morale building, but it certainly doesn't need this. Look at this, it's at 16. All right, so you can go over to manufacture or research. Oh, I'm sorry. With a cultural festival. Cultural festival. Why the file of this stream is bugged? Probably because the stream crashed earlier today. I don't know. I'll take a look at it when I'm done streaming and see if I can figure it out. All right, Tavana, just finish your stadium because you're halfway done, and then go on to research. We already looked at Money Bin. This planet's almost done too. I don't think it even needs to up. Well, we might as well get the approval while we can. Jurassic World. All right, I don't think we need anything here. Just do some research. I'm sorry, Cultural Festival. That name is so funny. Jurassic World's kind of a small planet. Look at this world, jeez. Yeah, so planetary soil right there. Basic factory. This planet has so much production, it's getting to be absurd, and then I'm gonna put that Thalen thing in there. Come on. There we go. And by the way, my influence is like really dominant too, and I have not put a huge effort into pumping influence. Partly it's just by having high morale, you get that effect, because the AI is not especially good at managing morale, except on the high difficulty where they get ridiculous cheats. For the most part, the AI doesn't manage its morale very well. And of course, there's a morale bonus for having high morale. For having, yeah, there's a morale bonus for having high morale. There's an influence bonus for having high morale. Thank you. Can finally talk. All right. So then the next thing I'll probably do is I'll probably crank out some more. Let's get a few more. Actually, let's design a new sensor ship and get a couple of these so I have vision of the whole map. It's abusive, but I don't care. Here we go again. I probably got to stop soon. I think I'll play to turn 50. All right, sensor version 2. Well, I don't need the extra moves, and I don't think I need the extra ship range. New design. All right, we do want one ion, so we can get 6 moves. But I don't think we need extra range, because these are just going to be for spotting enemies incoming. There we go. All right, so this gives us 20 sensor range. That works. That works. Not a lot of range, only 12 tiles, but that's fine. Well, I'd rather have the extra range. I'd rather have 22 range and 19 sensor than one extra tile. Actually, isn't that the. No, wait, that's the same ship I already have. Never mind. That's exactly the same ship I already have. That is the Sensor V2. Exactly the same ship. All right, so we'll just build a couple of them. Couple of them. All right. So Thala's done upgrading basically everything. I guess we might as well do the stadium while we're here. That'll finish that in one turn. Hold on, are these planets actually researching? McFly's upgrading. All right, so like this planet, it was not actually set to research. Wow, that's 87 beakers. Nice. Baba Yetu, McFly, Dirty Tech, 87 beakers. Atlantis, good. Havana, wow, Havana is like done too. All right, cool. Research. Yeah, now we finally have a lot of research coming in. Now here's where we just blow past the AI in tech, like to a ridiculous extent. All right, upgrade that. Might as well upgrade that, because why not? While we're here, just so I don't have to worry about it again. Just get them while I'm doing all of them at once. This planet, Jurassic World's doing research. Oh, we got that? Okay, cool. That. Okay. Alrighty, so how many beakers are we getting now? 228, that's pretty good. We've got another constructor. So what can we upgrade here? Oh, we can upgrade and get more production or more morale. More morale, maybe. I'm not sure if these planets really need it. Or we can come down here and boost these planets. We should probably do that. Which is the planet that has the influence or the morale penalty? One of them has a morale penalty. Not McFly, so that one's okay. I think it's one of these two worlds, isn't it? One of them has an issue that like penalizes it. Not that one. Anyway, I can't remember. But anyway, we'll come down here and build the star base to support these two planets. Why not? Provides more influence anyway, if nothing else. All right, so yeah, let's play to turn 50 and go from there. I know that there's not anything that exciting going on, but I don't know. It's kind of fun to do a laid-back game that's not super tense or anything. All right, so that was to get access to the financial center. The shopping center is nice. That's the tier 2 market. So all that will keep our finances in good shape. Okay. Back to this tree. Gaia Theory, that's what we want. So we can build that ludicrously overpowered Thalen thingy. All right. Done with social here. Give me 100% manufacturing. 171, not bad. So I'm gonna put my manufacturing capital right there on that tile. I'll be getting that soon. It's like a national wonder, as I've said before. All right, so Thala. All right, this planet is done. Well, actually, no, we need to upgrade this again. Baba Yetu. All right, Baba Yetu is the one that has. Yeah, it has the solar flare, minus 10% morale. That's the planet that. One of the ones that has that. All right, McFly upgrading. Research, research, research. Research. Here we go. Let's finish the Xeno Factory. We don't need that entertainment network anytime soon. So do that, and then upgrade the markets. Upgrade the markets, and then let's get the financial center after that. But these are much cheaper to upgrade. Yeah, we'll do that. How much are those shopping centers? All right, let's do this. So the shopping centers cost 15 production, so let's or 45, so let's do that in. That way they're 3-turn builds. Gotta micromanage this money bin. All right, research. Almost done here. Okay. And we're still in the black after all, so. Still looking good. All right. Oh, whoops, there's nothing over there. Okay. Whatever. So this ship. I'm not sure where we'll post this one. Probably over here because it's in this area. My goal is to have sensor ships that just reveal the entire map, because why not? I like playing with map hacks, don't you? Why not play the game with map hacks? We can just see everything that happens. All right, so turn 50. Here's our first sensor ship. You go over to the far west and sit like there, something like that. Let's see. You come sit like right there. Oh, crud, we're going through your space. They're not gonna like that. Oh well, they just have to live with it. I'm gonna play one more turn because I want to get this Gaia Theory done. I know, the infamous one more turn. Can't help myself. Yeah, by the way, the sensorships have been nerfed since release. I know that might seem hard to believe with how strong they are, but they actually have been nerfed since release. The original ones were even stronger. By the way, we can research, if we really want to, we can research the next tier of sensorships. That is possible to do that, but it's not crucial or anything. Anyway, so what do we want? We still don't need the farms yet. The planets are not near the cap. So let's go for the tier 3. Why not go for the tier 3 mega factories and research labs? Why not? And let's just go for the research specialization. We have enough production. Why not? This would be a, yeah, like a one-turn tech. Exactly. Okay. Haley has conveniently finished all its builds just in time to do the... Where is it? Gaia Vortex. Wow, can do it in 2 turns? Jeez. And look at the bonuses. +3 to everything. Jeez. Wow, okay. We'll take that. Wow, okay. Gaia Vortex. This planet's going to be pretty ridiculous. And in a good way. Alright, I'm just checking to make sure if I'm missing anything. Alright, so Baba Yetu needs to go over to research. By the way, remember, the Gaia Vortex is going to pump up every single planet in my territory. Cue that up as well. A dirty tech. So yeah, this game's been very relaxing, very easy. Just the land grab was everything. So yeah, now we've got the shopping centers coming in, which will increase the wealth of the planet further. And then I can build the financial capital. Hopefully by the time I build them, I'll be able to go more production on that world. Jurassic World. All right, looking good. Yep, I'm sorry, Trenlo. Looks like we're almost just about done here. As I said, 50 turns is a good... So let's look at some stats, shall we? Let me save the game before I forget. All right, so this one's going to be called Balin's OP, because at least in this galaxy map they are. I'm just kind of shocked I could land grab this effectively. But anyway, let's check the victory panel. We're already 50%, we're already over halfway to an influence victory, and I'm not even trying to win an influence victory. Tech victory, yeah. You have to go a long way to get a tech victory. I'm 14% of the way there. I have no ascension crystals. By the way, I think this is a new graphic. I don't remember seeing this previously. And diplomatic, you have to ally with everybody else, which I haven't done yet. Sorry, Trenla, I know. Timing has always been kind of awkward. Here's the colonies. Look at this. We have just enough colonies to fit all of them on the screen at once. So you can see there's everybody marching in lockstep at 100% morale. Now, this screen is actually useful because you can see the research of every planet. And you can see what they're costing you in terms of money. Looking good there. What is this? This influence? What does this mean? 1.5? Interesting. Okay. Why is this one 2.0? Oh, because it has the leftover robots, I suppose. Anyway, and production, can see my two manufacturing worlds are Thala and Haley. McFly has surprisingly high manufacturing. Oh, because it has 2 factories? Huh. Interesting that... Oh, I know why it's high. Because it's one of the only worlds building infrastructure. The others are all on research. That's why they're so low. Commands, trade. I got the 2 trade routes. I mean, the trade routes just don't really do that much. They're not that valuable. All right, so anyway. Faction power. Interesting that the Iconians have been creeping up lately. I still don't even know how they calculate this. Economic power... I don't know what this one is. Wealth? Oh, it's your wealth per turn, I think. Military power. We still have no ships. Not a single military ship. If somebody were to get aggressive, though, we could fix that real fast. Population, we're just taking off, and the AI is stuck because they don't have planets. Influence. Apparently, we've plateaued on influence for whatever reason. Raw production, yeah. When I built the hives and then a steady population growth... Iconians are getting a little bit more. Social manufacturing, military manufacturing, research. Yeah, can you see when I turned on research for the first time? Yeah, there you go. Finally turned on research. And now they're just in the dust. Approval, treasury, and ascension. All right, so that gives us some bar graphs to mess around with. How close are we on ideology? We're at 31 points. We're getting there. We actually are getting... I've got a fair number of those missionary centers. How many do I have total? Let's just count. Let's see, so the capital, that's what they look like, by the way. Each one gives 1/10 of a point per turn. So that's one. I have one on this planet too, right? Okay, that's 2. I don't have one on this planet. I'd like to put one. That's 2. I guess I don't have that many. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. Yeah, so I get almost 1 point per turn. Not bad. So I am slowly creeping along towards these, the next one. This is the one we're going to grab next. Each colony receives one tile, and then maybe we'll eventually get this, although I think the game might be over before that, but grants a class 16 planet. Very worthwhile. Anyway, so yeah, that's where we stand. Might do a little bit more of this tomorrow. We'll see. It'll depend. We'll see how we're feeling, but this was fun. I enjoyed it, and I hope some of you enjoyed watching. Sorry for the stream crashes constantly. Anyway, hope your weekend's off to a great start. I should be around at some point tomorrow. Until then, have a good one. See you guys soon, and take care.